Ciao a tutti ragazzi and welcome back to another video. It's been a long time, I admit it, it's been a long time, but I guess you won't mind because I'm the only person that watches my own videos, so it's not a big problem. I'm sorry for the noise you're going to hear in the background, but my microphone is having a bit of troubles right now and I haven't figured out how to fix it yet. By the way, what we're going to be doing today is I'm going to show you how to build a medieval-style house. As you may have noticed, I'm not playing vanilla Minecraft. Actually, I'm using a mod pack, which is from Westeros Craft, which is an awesome server. Basically, Westeros Craft is a server based on the series Game of Thrones, and what they're doing here is they are recreating block by block the entire world of Game of Thrones, so Westeros. If, like me, you love Game of Thrones, go and check this server out. It's absolutely amazing. They've recreated stuff like the wall in the north or King's Landing, and it's absolutely mental. If you have never watched Game of Thrones, leave everything you're doing right now and go and watch it. Trust me, you won't regret it. What we are going to do today is we are going to build a house in the style you saw earlier, because I'm actually trying to apply as a builder for this server, and trust me, this is taking a lot of time, and I'm talking months. They're really, really selective in who they pick as builders. I guess this is in order to avoid griefers as well. By the way, I am going to start building it and I'm going to make a couple of process updates. The cool thing about this mod pack is that it adds a lot of new blocks, and this allows me to use a lot of different color schemes and make all the buildings look way more detailed and well, cool. What I always like to do before starting to build this, I like to you know, store all the kind of blocks I'm going to use in the building so that I can pick them up with pushing the wheel of my mouse, and so I don't have to browse all of the enormous amount of items I have here. As you can see, I have already placed the walls and they don't look like anything special at all. This is because right now I have used just one type of blocks. The first advice I'm giving you is never use only one kind of blocks when building something in Minecraft, when building anything in Minecraft. What you have to do is, in fact, try to create some random patterns using different type of blocks, like this. In this build I am going to kind of create a shade which starts from a darker color in the on the bottom and goes lighter on the way up. So never forget to use at least two or three kind of blocks when building something like that. So this is the color scheme that I'm going to work on, and now I'm going to work in order to don't make it look like a big pile of bricks. One way to make everything look less squared is to use stairs in different way. By placing them like this, you can sort of simulate missing bricks and make everything look a bit more detailed and hopefully better. So now that we have the main part done, we can start worrying about the roof. What I chose to use for this building is this black slate material, which I think will look really good with this kind of cold colors I'm using here. So here's the roof done, and as you can see, it's starting to look like a proper house. Now, in order to don't leave it like a big rectangle in the field, we are going to add a new part of this house here with another sloping roof like this. So here it is done, and I decided to use wood instead of slate because I thought it kinda fits better here. with these colors I have. So now that we have the whole structure made, I can start to work on the entrance and the windows and all the decorating. So I just completed this part, and I just wanted to mention something. One of the cool things about Minecraft is that you can build stuff that could not exist in real life. But when we're trying to build something as realistic as possible, we must try to make everything look like it could hold itself up in real life. So don't forget to put pillars and rafters to make everything look more stable. And there's a pig in my house. At this point, we can start to work on the interiors of the house. So remember, we always need to make sure that these buildings look real, so we need to place more rafters, because as it is now, it would certainly fall apart. In my opinion, it's always better to start with placing the stairs, because then you can build the whole room around them. So I've now finished placing the supports, and I think that I can now go ahead and place the second floor. I'm going to use slabs because they make the logs pop out and they look much better in my opinion. So we have this situation on the ground floor, and another advice I need to give you is when you're building the interiors of a house, don't leave big open spaces, because they are very difficult to fill. In fact, right now I think I'm going to put some other logs here to make this even more packed. On this floor instead, we have this big open space that we are going to need to divide in at least two smaller rooms. This is also where the bedroom is going to be. Of course, when building in such small places, the main risk is to run out of space. Fortunately, this modpack adds blocks like this. They are made just for that reason, and the trick stays just in learning how to use them effectively. Another thing you need to keep in mind is to never neglect any side of the building, so try to decorate every single wall, and this is something you might need to do after you have in mind how you're going to decorate the insides, because you cannot place a window where maybe you want to build a chimney or something like that. Speaking of interns, one really important thing is to be able to use blocks creatively, and I'll show you some examples in a little bit. What I mean by using items creatively is to use them not necessarily for the purpose they were initially made for. For example, you can make a shelf out of a fence gate and a trapdoor, or a table out of this chain thingy and a carpet. So I just finished building everything, and I don't really know if I like this stuff I've made here, but I guess I cannot leave it without it, so I leave it this way. So now I'm going to free you from my annoying voice and microphone sound, and I'm going to leave you to a tour of the house, and I'll see you next video.